Simple Cyber Defense Security Updates for October 23rd, 2021. Welcome back to Simple Cyber Defense. In this week episode, we're going to be talking about working from home and the possible risks of doing so. My name is Carl.
Hi, this is Mon.
Let's start with the episode. All right. So, I was listening to a podcast the other day in which they were talking about how working from home can present a risk both in the corporate world and your home network. It was a very interesting topic because they noticed that a lot of people who are working from home due to the pandemic and things noticed that a lot of personal devices were showing up on corporate networks. And many of the home people working from home didn't really notice this or didn't know about it. And the reasoning behind it is because when you bring home a corporate-owned computer, they have usually monitoring software on there to monitor the devices to make sure that it doesn't have malware on it or any other unwanted software to that would be able to steal information from the company, and rightfully so, because the businesses have to protect their assets, make sure that they're not going to be attacked by cyber attacks. But some of these monitoring softwares were a little bit too aggressive, and which after the people brought their computers home, they connected them to their home networks, and then the software would then monitor everything on that network, including all IoT devices that are connected to it, all smart TVs, and basically anything connected to their home network was monitored by the software. And the reasoning behind this from the IT's perspective is because it is easy for an attacker to take an IoT device, take it over, and then jump onto the person's home network, and then from there jump onto the corporate laptop. And then when the person logs in for their day through the VPN, it would then migrate its way from the corporate laptop over to the corporate network and then steal whatever information they can. This has been seen a lot of times, especially the most famous case was in Las Vegas, which they had a very secure network that was very locked down. But someone had the idea that wouldn't it be great to have a monitoring software that would monitor a fish tank? So that they put in a little device that would monitor the fish tank cleaning. And unfortunately, that device wasn't very secured. So the hackers were able to attack the fish tank monitoring software, and then from there get into the private network of the casino and basically took over the entire network. So businesses started learning that IoT devices can be a very big problem. And so this is the reason why these monitoring softwares are there, is to prevent IoT devices, which usually does not have a lot of security on them, to prevent it from being used as a pivot point or a way to compromise one device and then get access to other devices through that compromised device.
How do you feel about that reasoning from corporations saying that we have to monitor the rest of your personal network to ensure the safety and security of our device and our corporate network through your device?
I mean, a personal level, I don't really like the idea that someone else is looking into my personal network. And I think it really should stop at the company-owned property. And I think the best way to have that happen is to have a segmentation in your network. A lot of these newer modems, or not modems, but routers, allow you to create what's known as a guest network. And these guest networks are a special little separate network from your home network, so that anything that connects to the guest network will not be able to see anything else on your personal network. So it's kind of like a set, like it's the routing makes basically two separate little networks together without any special additional software or additional knowledge. So you just go into the routing settings and click on one of the settings that says create a guest network and create a different SSID or a name for it, and possibly another password for it if you want to keep it super secure. And so that way, when you connect your corporate laptop to the guest network, the monitoring software would only be able to monitor just the computer and nothing else on the network, because it will only see just the computer and the outside internet, and that's it. So that's a way to protect your home network from being monitored by the entire corporation. And it's also a good idea, if you do have IoT devices, to also connect them to a guest network, so that if your IoT device does get compromised, it doesn't see the rest of the devices on your home network. It just sees just that one IoT device.
As far as from the corporate side, so it doesn't require me as an end user to do anything to my home network. If they were to just install a host-based firewall or a host-based intrusion prevention system just on that company device, mm-hmm. would that be enough to protect the corporate network from any malware that may get to my computer while it's on my own network?
Yes, it would, but the problem with that is they would have to not only install it on every single device that they have, but also monitor those separately. So all those logs would be just local to each computer. So they would have to collect those logs from each and every device that the corporate has, the entire corporation. So that's the reason why they usually do a centralized little centralized firewall or centralized monitoring software, and then just have it connect to all the different devices and then monitor the devices remotely, rather than trying to each individually lock up those with the firewalls and intrusion prevention things, because it would require them to individually have to monitor and take care of them on an individual level. So if they have to update a rule or something, they'd have to send it to each individual computer that's connected. And sometimes these corporations have thousands upon thousands of different computers that are out there, so it's not really feasible for them to do that. So that's why they do like one central thing, that they update one thing and then it just gets pushed out to everything that gets connected to it. So it's just an easier way for them to monitor, so that they don't have to deal with individual devices. That makes sense.
But doesn't a mobile device management software also need the same type of work? If you still need to install on each computer, you still need to monitor from each computer. So wouldn't it be the same amount of work except on a different type of solution?
Well, the thing with the mobile device things, you're downloading an app, and then that app connects to a central server. And all the different instructions in that are sent to that central server. And then as the app connects to the server, then it downloads the information it needs. So if there's an update, as the app communicates to the server, says, okay, I'll grab this update. So that's way the company only deals with one server, but each individual mobile device connects to the central server to get their updates and whatever they need from there.
Okay. One of the issues that, you know, we deal with is when you have your own personal device and you get the option of, you know, bring your own device, and then the IT would create a partition on it just for, you know, your company work, or you choosing to have a secondary device. You know, most of us opt to use a company device or use our own device because we don't want to carry two laptops, or you don't want to carry two iPads or two cell phones. And now this option is just as risky now if you choose to just have a company owned, you know, device on your own network. To me, it's just as risky because you're still getting the same type of monitoring as long as you connect it to your network. You know, and yeah, so it's kind of I think, you know, we talked about before, there's got to be more regulation when it comes to things like this. You know, even on a between an employee and a company relationship, most of us feel, okay, when I'm off the clock, I'm off the clock. You have nothing to do with me. You know, this is my own personal life. But now you're literally being monitored 24/7. And it's not just you, it's everybody else on your network. You know, you can be your kids' laptops, you can be your, you know, your spouse's laptops, your Netflix watch history, your cameras in, you know, on your Ring cam outside.
Or even your Amazon shopping history.
Yeah, you're exactly. And
it's like, there's no end. Cause
yeah.
You say with the bring your own devices, the line between personal data and company data is starting to get blurred a little bit too much, and it's starting to overlap a lot, and it's getting really hard to separate unless you have like a separate device to segmentate the two informations, and that does become cumbersome because then you have to carry out the two laptops or like the two cell phones, two everything, but. Hey. That's the only way to 100% guarantee that your personal life will stay personal and your corporate life will stay corporate.
There is another option instead of segmenting your network or creating a guest network is if your company requires you to work remotely and connect to the internet, require from your employer an internet connected device or a connection device like a hotspot. Say, hey, you expect me to be on for 8 to 10 hours a day? Then you supply me with a hotspot, you know, and that's all. I remember, you only use that to connect your corporate device. That's it. And I think that would be another option for us who don't know how to segment a network, or for example, like I have a Comcast router that doesn't even allow a guest network. Somebody that, you know, that visits your home, you have to give them the Wi-Fi network, you know, unless you know how the Wi-Fi password, unless you know how to segment your own network, because the option of creating. Yeah.
And not everyone has the luxury to be able to buy a second router. To be
able exactly. To yeah. Yeah. And it's just, you know, it's how much can you do to just protect what's yours, you know?
Unfortunately, the businesses are not going to protect yourself, as we see from the loads of different data breaches that happened. And if you just give them just a little bit of control over your personal network, they'll just take a mile.
Right.
And they'll just say, well, it's for our security.
Right. And I wouldn't be surprised if you see, like, eventually in the future, and not very far in the future, people getting in trouble or losing their jobs or what they do on their own personal time, just because it may have caused something to the, you know, to the company device, even if you haven't used the company device.
Well, there's even some stories about people losing their jobs over a Facebook post or a tweet or something else.
Right.
And I have my personal opinions about that, but that's not relevant to what we're talking about now. But yeah, when it comes to cybersecurity, again, it's up to us to protect ourselves, because the businesses will just protect themselves. And if we don't start pushing back, saying, hey, this is my personal space, you're not allowed in here, they're going to keep creeping their ways in there in guise of security and all that. But again, we have to have a separation between our personal lives and our company lives, because like you said, I don't want to get fired over something that I do personally that really doesn't have any effect on the company, but the company just says, oh, well, because we see this on your network, it's a threat, so we're just going to get rid of you before you become a threat to us.
Right. That's yeah.
It's insane. Again, that line is blurring up. Right now, we still have a little bit of segmentation, but like you said, in the future, it could easily just overlap so much that they're one and the same, and we can't allow that to happen.
Yeah. You know, the thing that strikes me is, you know, when you told me about this, I was really taken aback, you know, about the podcast that you just mentioned earlier in the episode. I mean, companies have many other options. I mean, to do this, like, you know, there is mobile, there's content management, there is, you know, mobile, you know, application monitoring. They can do, there's so many things that they can do that wouldn't require much, you know.
The problem is it requires costs, and companies don't want to put that cost on there, because corporations usually see security as a cost and not a benefit. So that's right. Why they try to go the cheapest route possible, even if it is the least secure. It all boils down to money.
Right. Yeah, I mean, no. Remember, you're the only one who can protect you out there is just yourself. Really, don't, you know. So the best advice is learn as much as you can. I mean, with our presence ever evolving online, it falls upon us. It's a personal responsibility now to learn how to protect yourself in the digital world.
Yeah, because companies are only going to look out for themselves. And so, unfortunately, we have to band ourselves together and look out for ourselves, too.
That right.
Includes learning as much as we can about different simple tools that we can use to protect our digital assets, protect our digital lives, and it's just going to get worse until either government step in or we just have enough, and then we just fight back against the company saying, hey, no, this is not going to happen because I'm not going to allow it to. And if all of us come together like that, then they can't fire us all.
Right. Right.
If only one or two people are standing up, yeah, they can just get rid of those one or two people. But again, if we all stand together in unity to push back, then they can't get rid of everyone.
Right.
All right. So, is there anything else you want to add?
No.
All right. I think that will end this episode. And remember, it's vital to keep your personal life and your company life separated by any means that you can, whether it's requiring a corporate phone and a personal phone, or having the ability to create a guest network on your router, or asking for a hotspot to be provided if you're being required to work from home. Just whatever little things you can do to keep yourself safe. And that will end it this week. And look forward to seeing you in the next episode.
If you like what was in this episode, please consider liking, subscribing, and sharing with others. For more information, to suggest a topic, or to donate, head over to simplecyberdefense.com.